So in the final part of our discussion, well, we have seen all the characters in this group. So now from Fagwa to Jannat Graveyard to Jantar Mantar to Kashmir to Dandak Army, these all stories are connected with, and at the end we have even this true story that is resolved, that who is Zabin II, who is Utiya, who is the daughter of Revati, who was a Maoist. And that story is resolved, and ultimately we get that she is a child of six fathers, the six policemen who raped Revati, and three mothers, Revati, Tilottama and Anjum. That's how that story goes there. And then we had this Kashmir story, which was still hanging about Captain Amrik Singh, and we come to know that he committed suicide, but terror groups and the terrorists were very much behind him to see that either they kill himself or they will kill. The self-destructive idea, which becomes very symbolic, to look at an idea that whenever anybody, any power, when they try to overpower a land or the people, the history obviously goes against those powerful people. Someday, somehow, those people, that land will get free, liberated, they will get their voice, they will get their language, and then what way the things will be narrated will be completely else, completely different way. The entire history will be written about all those episodes also. Well, so in the final part, the title of the final part is Gui Kong, which is a very interesting word. Now, what is this Gui Kong? Again, very difficult to see the exact meaning. But many of the animals and birds and insects are given some curious names, like there is a mare, a she-horse, mare who is known as Pyle. There are this saffron parakeets, there are vultures, there is a crow, there are bats, and in that, again you have one interesting insect here to end the story, one insect with which the story ends, and that insect is dung beetle. Dung beetle, who is known as Gui Kong, dung beetle. Podra ma rehto kido. Dung is the podro. Beetle, the kido. That is that dung beetle, who is known as Gui Kong, with which it ends. So, well. So it was Musa's third night at Jannat guest house, he says, and then we were delighted to see the thing. And when Musa was staying there, third and the last night, when he was there, he was happy with Ustani ji. Now, who is this Ustani ji? As Tilottama is known as Ustani ji also. As Tilottama, Ustani ji. Now Ustan ji or Ustani ji is the feminine in Urdu of Ustad. Ustad and Ustani. Ustad means teacher. Ustad means teacher. Ustani means she teacher. So she is now teaching so many kids at Jannat graveyard, Jannat place, where she is a teacher also to the slum dwellers there. So that's how she is known as Ustani ji also. So Musa is staying there, last lines are there with them, and when Musa is reading something that is written by Tilo, Tilottama is known as Tilo, by and large in the entire narrative, short form Tilo is used for Tilottama. And it is here that refers to one of the couplets in different way. Mar gaye bulbul kafas mein keh gaye sayad se. So that refers to that, which is repeatedly coming in different way here. And it says that I want this to be epitaph on my grave when I die. I want this to be epitaph. At that time, when she says this, when I die, Tilo said laughing, I want this to be my epitaph. Now, at that time, Arundhati Roy is writing, Ahlam Baji muttered a few insults and turned over in her grave. એ જ્યાં ગેસ્ટ હાઉસમાં રહે છે જે રૂમ એમાં નીચે કબર છે અહલમબાજી. હુ ઇઝ અહલમબાજી? અહલમબાજી ઇઝ હિયર. અહલમબાજી ઇઝ ધ મિડવાઇફ હુ ગેવ બર્થ ટુ આફતાબ. Now see, suddenly the last page gets connected with the first page. When Aftab was the Ahlam Baji, and he grave shetya, and he kabar ma ye padkhu pherve chhe. That is the reference. That is the surrealism that is coming back again in the last part. Musa glanced at the page in the notebook that faced the one in which Tilo had written the poem. And this was that poem which we referred yesterday also. Which becomes a kind of a theme to or a way to read at this novel. And that is this, that how to tell a shattered story. How to tell a shattered story. If we can see it here in this camera, if I can record, then it is this how it is coming. How to tell a shattered story. By slowly becoming everybody. By slowly becoming everybody? No. By slowly becoming everything. By slowly becoming everything. That is how. So this is a shattered story. The story has no structure as such. It is symbolically like a perforated sheet of Salman Rushdie. Perforated sheet. Which again is that story is a perforated sheet. The same with this also is a very shattered kind of a story. And it takes lots of time in connecting the interlinks with all the characters and all the stories together also. So this was there, and then he refers that something about Tilo's new home reminded Musa of the story of Mumtaz Afzal Malik. This new home, that is this Jannat, Jannat in graveyard. It reminded Musa of the story of Mumtaz Afzal Malik. And what is the story? The young taxi driver. Mumtaz, now Mumtaz seems to be a name of a lady, but here it is a taxi driver, whom Amrik Singh had killed. Amrik Singh killed so many innocent people. Among them, this is another story of this, whose body had been recovered from a field and delivered to his family with earth in his clenched fists and mustard flowers growing through his fingers. So when the body was delivered to family, with the clenched face, there was a hand, mitti in the hand, and that mitti already flowers have started growing. Also, in the fist of a dead man, the flowers growing. So that is the graveyard and Jannat. That is the meaning of this place here also. So this things, and the last paragraph. Then Anjum Musa lived, and that was the last time he was found, and he was killed in one of the encounters. By the security force and terrorist there. Anjum was restless that night and unable to sleep. Last night, last scene of the novel. Anjum was restless that night and was not able to sleep. She pottered around the graveyard inspecting her property. She stopped for a moment at Bombay Silk's grave and said a prayer and told Miss Udaya Zeban, who was perched on her lips, the story of how she had first set eyes on Bombay Silk. So initial story, Bombay Silk, little boy in a gallery watching Bombay Silk and goes behind to Khwabga. So that is connected here in the last part there. Then it says buying bangles from a bangle seller at Chitli Kabar. Chitli Kabar also is an interesting cover of a goat. Ek bakri ni kabar hati. And tyar pan logo mannat manta. Chitli Kabar was there. So near there was a bangle seller in this. She bent down and picked up one of Roshan Lal's flowers from Begum Renata Mumtaz Madam's grave and put it on Comrade Masi's. Comrade Masi is Revati. Revati is Comrade Masi's. M-A-A-S-E, Comrade Revati is known as M-A-A-S-E. To this, So now this last night and all these figures suddenly are remembered in form of graves that are there in the graveyard. The little act of redistribution made her feel much better. She looked back at Jannat guest house with a sense of contentment and accomplishment. On impulse, she decided to take Miss Udaya Zabel out on a brief midnight ramble to familiarize her with her surroundings and see the city lights. Udaya Zabel, Miss Udaya, ajhi ungna thi aavti. To chalo anani maaki ne ek chakar marao shahar mein. E riti ne lai ne, let me go out there. So Miss Udaya Zabel, the second one here, the daughter of Revati. Now the mother is Anjum here. This is the last two paragraphs here. She walked past the mortuary, through the hospital car park, onto the main road. There wasn't much traffic at that hour. Still, to be safe, they stayed on the pavement, threading their way through the rickshaws and other kinds of things there. When Miss Udaya Zabel said, "Mummy, Susu." Now this, even urinating and that also is symbolically, repeatedly coming. One night when Anjum and they were coming, it was a time of emergency and Sanjay Gandhi and their police was behind them and this hijras were running over a flyover, it was raining and then she had Susu in her Ghagra. That is what she refers and tells the story of that to Zainab also when she was a baby and recalls that episode comes into the mind when this little girl, baby says, "Mummy, Susu." Anjum set her down under a street light with her eyes fixed on her her mother. She peed and then lifted the bottom to marvel at the night sky and the stars and the 1,000-year-old city reflected in the puddles he had made. Now this is a very curious imagery of the thing that the urinated puddle that she has made. She is looking the reflection of the lights and all those things in that. Anjum gathered her up and kissed her and took her home, the last paragraph. By the time they got back, the lights were out, all out, and everybody was asleep. Everybody, that is, except for Gui Kyon. Bada sui gya tha kwan? Gui Kyon e noto sutu. So the title, Gui Kyon, that comes here. Gui Kyon, the dung beetle. Gui Kyon, the dung beetle, was not asleep. He was wide awake and on duty. He was wide awake and on duty, lying on his back with his legs in the air to save the world in case the heavens fell. Now this is very interesting. One has to see how dung beetles work. Dung beetles who kaam kare and kem kaam kare. અને કેટલું મહત્વનું કામ કરે આપણા માટે મનુષ્ય માટે આ પૃથ્વી ઉપર કેટલું બધું મહત્વનું કામ ડંગ બીટલ કરી રહ્યા છે એ જોઈએ તો જ ખ્યાલ આવે આવી ઇમેજરી ક્યાં છે મે બી ટુમોરો વી વિલ સી અ વિડિયો બટ યુ કેન ઓલસો જસ્ટ ગૂગલ ઇટ આઉટ એન્ડ સી ડંગ બીટલ અને આ ડંગ બીટલ ઊંધું પડ્યું છે આ ઊંધું પડેલું ડંગ બીટલ એટલે કદાચ થાકીને હોય મરવા સમયે હોય તો કામ કરીને થાકી ગયું હોય એટલે ઊંધું પડી ગયું હોય તો જ્યારે કામ કરતો હોય ત્યારે ઊંધું પણ થઈ જાય બીટલ એટલે બી જેવું જાડું આવે અને એ ઊંધું થઈ જાય તો એને ચડતું થતાય વાર બહુ લાગે એનો સંઘર્ષ પૂરો પડતો એ જાણે આમ ઊંધું પડ્યું છે એનું કામ પૂરું કરીને ને વોટ ઇઝ ધ વર્ક ધેટ ડંગ બીટલ્સ ડુ ધે મેક બોલ્સ ઓફ ડંગ ધે મેક રાઉન્ડ બોલ્સ પછી ધે પુશ ધેટ બોલ બોલને લઈને જમીનમાં ઊંડે ઊંડે લઈ જાય અને એ એમનું ભોજન પણ બનાવે એમાં એનું ફેમિલી પણ થાય ધેર આર ડિફરન્ટ કાઇન્ડ્સ ઓફ ડંગ બીટલ્સ વેર ધે વર્ક બટ પીપલ સે ઇકોલોજિસ્ટ સે ધેટ ધીસ ઇઝ અ વેરી ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ વર્ક આમાં એ કેટલા બધા બીજને જમીનમાં વાવેતર કરતા હોય છે જંગલો આને લીધે બનતા હોય છે સો લોટ્સ ઓફ એન્વાયરમેન્ટલ ફ્રેન્ડલી વર્ક ઇઝ ડન બાય ડંગ બીટલ્સ અને ઊંડે ઊંડે ખેતીમાં એ ખાતર લઈ જાય છે જ્યાં મૂળમાં જરૂર હોય રૂટ્સને ત્યાં એ ડંગના ગોળાઓ લઈ જાય છે So it is helping the plants in growing also. So that work of dung beetle is very eco-friendly work. Now see, we started with vultures. Our urge to eat this butterscotch and nutty and ice creams and then the killing of vultures because of that. and then the dung beetle, nanakru dung beetle, એ પણ કેવું કામ કરતું હોય કે જે અર્થ ફ્રેન્ડલી એન્વાયરમેન્ટ ફ્રેન્ડલી હોય. સો ઇટ વોઝ લાઈન ઊંધું એ રીતે પડ્યું હતું કે જાણે ઉપરથી કદાચ સ્વર્ગો પડે તો જાણે પૃથ્વીને બચાવવાનું હોય કે એ ટેકો કરશે કે નહીં પૃથ્વીને નષ્ટ નહીં થવા દે. ઇવન ઇફ ધ હેવન્સ ફેલ ઇઝ અ મેટાફર, ઇઝ અ વોટ વી કોલ એક રૂપક તરીકે અથવા કહાવત તરીકે ઉપયોગ કરે, એટલે મોટી મુસીબત આવે, મોટી મુસીબત માટે હેવન્સ ફેલ, વેન ધ હેવન્સ ફેલ, એટલે ત્યારે બહુ મોટી કાયનાત આવે, મોટી મુસીબત આવે ત્યારે ત્યારે પૃથ્વીને કોણ બચાવશે? તો આ ડંગ બીટલ. બટ ધેટ ઇઝ વોટ ધ લાસ્ટ સીન ઇઝ ટ્રાઇંગ ટુ સે. બટ ઇવન હી ન્યુ દેટ થિંગ્સ વુડ ટર્ન આઉટ ઓલ રાઈટ ઇન ધ એન્ડ. કદાચ એ ડંગ બીટલને પણ એવી આસ્થા છે કે છેલ્લે બધું સારું થઈ જશે, છેલ્લે બધું સારું થઈ જશે. They would, because they had to. છેલ્લે તો સારું થવું જ જોઈએ, નહીં તો ત્યાં સુધી વાત પૂરી જ ન થાય. Because Miss Zeben, Miss Udaya Zeben was come. એ આવી છે એટલે હોપ આવ્યો છે અને પછી પાછું છેલ્લે સારું થશે જ એ હોપ સાથે this novel ends with all these stories there. So this is the story. So I hope with all these things that we have seen, maybe the entire narration, very complex structure of the narration, and the intricacies of so many stories, so separate stories interwoven together, also gets some sense here. So we have gone through, let me see, from here we started. Yeah, okay. So from, push this little bit this way. So from Genghis Khan or to Ramayan, from Ramayan to Hazrat Sarmad's story to the Quabuga story, and so many characters, they all have their own stories. We came down to Jannat graveyard and the story of Saddam Hussein, which remains an interesting story. From there to Jantar Mantar, the story of Jantar Mantar, and very interesting characters that come there, which links to the another story, and we come down to the Kashmir episode where Tilottama and the friends Musa, Hariharan, Biplab Das Gupta, they have their own story to tell us. And from there we have that curious baby found on Jantar Mantar, and that curious baby gets connected with the story of Maoist or Naxalite story, and everything gets interwoven into what India we have today, the fabric of India. That, and whatever the good and the negative points India is battling as a nation, all those things gets connected with all these characters that are there. So I hope this might have made things very clear. What is this Ministry of Utmost Happiness? Kind of thing. It ends with a hope of happiness that ultimately we all will be happy with all kinds of troubles and the problems that we have. Ultimately people will be happy. When Saddam proposes a marriage with Zainab, Anjum obviously says that you are already on a suicidal track. Your purpose of life is to kill Shehrawat. It means that you will be in jail. And how can we agree to with you to marry Zainab? It means there is no future of Zainab. But then Saddam says that now I don't have that revenge motive. Now I think that things will be okay. He gives the reason that now things are happening in a different way. Now our people have awakened. And he gives that video clip of Una. And then says that, see, all these people have awakened. They go to collector and they say, we will not do this work. You carry out with all this work. So that awakening is coming, and now I don't have to take revenge. I forget that idea of revenge now. So that hatred is turning into love. Or love is winning in case of Saddam Hussein, which obviously Arundhati Roy says there are all other cases also, including the Naxalite and the Kashmir. Love has to win. Love has to win in that way, if everybody has to live happily. Otherwise, Captain Amrik Singh, who was self-destructive, perhaps we all will self-destroy us in the temperament of hatred. But well, things will happen good, because we have a new baby now. There is a new future generation is there, and we hopefully, positively look towards that. So that is that ministry of utmost happiness, the group of people living around Jannat guest house, they make their own ministry and they crave for utmost happiness for themselves or whoever comes to Jannat guest house, either living or dead, but they will have some kind of happiness, sukun they will have ultimately at the end of the day. Okay? So that is the entire thing there. Okay?